When it comes to developing, testing, and improving new technologies and solutions, maximum effectiveness and usability depends on collaboration. Recently, a team made up of government and industry partners attended an event known as MISPIX in order to work one-on-one with soldiers. This gave CBC researchers, including Matthew Brown, a systems engineer and project lead, a chance to receive invaluable feedback on the development of the autonomous equipment decontamination system.
Yeah, so the MISPIX event is a maneuver support, protection, and integration experiments. So this is an event that they hold every year where they're looking at gathering warfighter feedback on some chembio rad nuke related technologies. So this gives us a chance to get our technology, our capability in the hands of warfighters for some early feedback to help with future development.
The event also allowed the project's partners, including DEVCOM's Army Research Lab, to be on-site together when receiving feedback from the soldiers.
The technology that we brought to MISPIX this year is the autonomous robotic decontamination. We've been bringing the soldiers in, we introduced them to our platform, we kind of showed them an overview of how everything works, and then we trained them on driving up to the vehicle, tele-opping, and then actually starting the decom process. Everything about this is about soldiers, so their feedback has been super valuable for us.
During the event, the team trained a group of four soldiers on how to use their autonomous equipment decontamination system, then met with the soldiers to discuss ways of improving the technology.
It was very exciting meeting all the scientists and the engineers and seeing where their thought process was when creating these. Because in the military, we just get a bunch of equipment. Sometimes we use them, sometimes we don't. And especially being Seaborn, we have to teach a lot of people about like our job and what we do. So both of us coming together, I think it was very exciting.
As far as all my TDY trips go, this is probably one of my favorites. Getting to put my hands on some equipment that soldiers worldwide haven't even seen yet. It's gonna allow the developers to have the opinions of the people who are gonna actually be operating it, so that they have those answers, questions as far as what the soldier on the field is actually gonna need.
Equipped with warfighter feedback and a variety of resources from multiple organizations, the team has all the support it needs to optimize this groundbreaking technology.
I think the strengths that are magnified with the partnership is just that we have different strengths than they do. They brought us on because they didn't, you know, have anybody that could do robotic arm and manipulation, whereas we obviously don't know anything about chemical, and we haven't had our robots in the chemical scene before, so it's really exciting to have a whole another field that we can now kind of talk about. And then when we talk to other soldiers, they're like, oh, can you de-ice helicopters and things like that? And we're like, well, yeah, if you give us the picture, we can spray it. So I think just it opens a lot of doors when you are working with people that have different skill sets and knowledge base. So it's really great.
So government and industry kind of working together. It's been a great collaboration. We really work hard to make sure we deliver a technology capability for the warfighter for a lot of these integration and soldier touch points. But we really also have fun working together, but making sure we get the job done as well.